زين الدين العراقيين. إن شاء الله تعالى, I wanted to share with you, about you all a benefit. This is the chapter where the author رحمه الله is talking about the issue of رواية الأكابر عن الأصاغر, the narration, the elders taking narration from the youngsters. And he was specifically talking about آداب الشيخ المحدث. And so what he did was, before that, just to give you guys the context and understand what he was talking about, he's talking about restricting a age when a person can sit down and narrate hadiths. So inshallah ta'ala, I just wanted to show you some of the benefits inshallah ta'ala that are in it. When he brought the statements of those who restricted it to the age of 40 and some who said 50, he brought the statement of Qadi Al-Iyad rahimahullah in his Kitab Al-Ilma'. And he said the following. He said, وَاسْتِحْسَانُهُ هَذَا لَا يَقُومُ لَهُ حُجَّةً بِمَا قَالَ. So the one who says that it should be 50 or 40, their statement, there's really no proof to use that as an argument. Rather, he goes on to saying, وَكَمْ مِنَ السَّلَفِ الْمُتَقَدِّمِينَ فَمَنْ بَعْدَهُمْ مِنَ الْمُحَدِّثِينَ مَنْ لَمْ يَنْتَهِ إِلَى هَذَا السِّنِّ وَلَسْتَوْفَى هَذَا الْعُمْرَ وَمَاتَ قَبْلَهُ وَقَدْ نَشَرَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ وَالْحَدِيثِ مَا لَا يُحْصَى. He said, how many? He says, وَكَمْ مِنَ السَّلَفِ الْمُتَقَدِّمِينَ. How many scholars from the pious predecessors? فَمَنْ بَعْدَهُمْ, and those who came after them. مِنَ الْمُحَدِّثِينَ, from the scholars of hadith. مَنْ لَمْ يَنْتَهِ إِلَى هَذِ السِّنِّ, who actually never reached 50 or never passed 50 or never reached it. وَلَا اسْتَوْفَ هَذَا الْعُمْرَ, and they never completed that age. وَمَاتَ قَبْلَهُ, and they died before that. وَقَدْ نَشَرَ, and they spread. مِنَ الْعِلْمِ وَالْحَدِيثِ مَا لَا يُحْصَى, and they actually spread knowledge and the hadith, that which cannot be counted. And now he gives examples. He says, هذا عمر بن عبد العزيز توفي ولم يكمل الأربعين. عمر بن عبد العزيز died and he never finished 40. وسعيد بن الجبير لم يبلغ الخمسين, he never reached 50. وكذا إبراهيم النخعي وكذا, وهذا مالك قد جلس للناس ابن نيف وعشرين سنة وقيل ابن سبع عشرة والناس متوافرون وشيوخه ربيعة ربيعة الرأي وابن شهاب, يعني محمد بن شهاب الزهري, وابن هرمز ونافع وابن المنكدر وغيرهم. So Imam Malik رحمه الله, he sat to teach when his age was only 20 and odd, and it's also said ابن سبعة عشر, سبعة عشرة, and that he was 17. والناس متوافرون, and what he means by the ناس here, he means the علماء, were present at his time, وشيوخه, such as ربيعة وابن شهاب, like ربيعة الرأي, محمد بن شهاب الزهري, and ابن هرمز, whose name is right there at the bottom, عبد الرحمن بن هرمز الأعرج الهاشمي مولاهم, and نافع مولى بن عمر, وابن المنكدر, يعني محمد بن المنكدر رحمه الله, وغيرهم, and other than them, أحياء, they were alive, وقد سمع منه ابن شهاب, rather ابن شهاب الزهري, which is the teacher, had actually narrated from Imam Malik رحمه الله, which then falls into the chapter of رواية الأكابر عن الأصاغر. Also, and the hadith that he narrated from was حديث فريعة أختي أبي سعيد الخضري. And then he goes on to saying, ثم قال وكذلك الشافعي, and also Imam الشافعي, قد أخذ عنه العلم, knowledge was taken from him, في سن الحداثة, when he was young, وانتصب لذلك, and he sat down for it, في آخرين من الأئمة المتقدمين والمتأخرين. Many others like that. He also brings another point, which is وروى الخطيب, يعني خطيب البغدادي, in his جامع, جامع أخلاق الرأي وأداب السامع, من طريق بندار. The Bundar here is Muhammad ibn Bashar, Imam al-Hafid Abu Bakr Muhammad ibn Bashar al-Basri, ومن شيوخ أئمة الستة. قال قد كتب عني خمسة, five had written from me, five had written for me. يعني قرون هي من طبقات, levels of people. وسألوني التحديث, and they asked me to narrate from them. وأنا ابن 18 سنة. And I'm only 18. فاستحييت, I became shy. أن أحدثهم, to narrate to them in مدينة. فأخرجتهم, I took them out. إلى البستان, to a garden, to a far place outside the city of مدينة. فأطعمتهم, I gave them الرطبة. I gave them dates. وحدثتهم, and then I narrated it for them. And he also mentions from another الإمام الخطيب البغدادي الإمام السقاوي رحمه الله, says, ومن طريق أبي بكر الأعين قال كتبنا عن البخاري, we wrote from الإمام البخاري على باب الفريابي. And الفريابي here is his شيخ محمد بن يوسف الفريابي. وما في وجهه شعرة, there was no hair on the face of his الإمام البخاري. فقلت ابن كم كان, how old was he at that time؟ قال, he said, ابن 17 سنة. ابن 17 سنة, only 17. قال الخطيب, يعني خطيب البغدادي, وقد حدثت أنا, I also narrated, ولي 20 سنة حين قدمت من البصرة, when I came from Basra. كتب عني شيخنا أبو القاسم الأزهري أشياء أدخلها في تصانيفه وسألني فقرأتها عليه, وذلك في سنة 1240. Again, الإمام الخطيب البغدادي, he is saying that he narrated when he was only 20. Now something else amazed me, which is the كلام of أئمة علم. Look at the كلام of عبد الله بن المعتزي. He says, الجاهل صغير. الجاهل صغير. The ignorant one is small, he's young. وإن كان الشيخ, and even if he's old in age. والعالم, the scholar is كبير, one who is all big. وإن كان حدثا, even if he's young in age. Even if he's young in age. So inshallah ta'ala, I wanted to share this benefit with you all. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فإنه مني ومن الشيطان والله ورسوله بريئان منه. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.